We all want the best user experience for our customers. That's why in today's episode, we're going to see how Clavister Cloud Services can simplify your workflow and provide instant access to your services with a simple click. Hi, with me today is Matthias Nordland, our head of products, who is going to talk to us about cloud services. And we're going to start with a demo of how to provision a service.
Yep. We are releasing Clavister Cloud Services 3.1. And with that, it's a new onboarding experience for both partner and end customer. So that's something we'll demo. And then we'll demo a little bit how, as an end user, you log into the cloud service and how you use it.
This is my Clavister. I'm now going to log in as a partner to show how it looks like. So when you have signed in to my Clavister, you have the cloud service option. So cloud service. Clicking on that one, I can see that I don't have any cloud service instances associated with my company. And now I'm logged in as a partner, but this will look the same for an end customer or a partner. The only difference is when I do this request as a partner, I have the option to do it for myself or for one of my customers. In this demo, I will show how I do it for myself. So I create for my own. I get a tenant name. In this case, it's based on my partner name, Shield IT Partners. So it will propose a FQDN for me. I can change this one, and then it will do a new FQDN based on this name. The email and the phone number is really important that you have correct, because when I have read the terms and agreement and accepted this one, you will get an invite email to the email address. And when you do the onboarding, you will get a one-time SMS code to this mobile phone to verify that you have control over both. So it's really important that to verify that these are correct. You request provisioning. As soon as it's done, you will be notified through email. And then you can onboard into the service. And as you can see, you can always go into the cloud service to see the status. So it will be initiated. And then after it's done, it will be set provisioned.
Today, I will be talking with Michał Romanczuk, who is a front-end developer here at Clavister, and who has worked on the whole cloud services workflow. I understand that it has been more complicated than it is, Michał.
It was much more oriented at strictly technical people. You know, the current trends in UI and UX are generally to streamline things, keep them simple, both visually and functionally. And that's what we've been trying to accomplish here, basically by giving the whole UI a more modern approach, but also to streamline our whole process, so that the user isn't required to, you know, open up hostile-looking text terminals, and that as much of the stuff that we can is available at the push of a button.
So now you have recorded a little demo to show us the whole process from the user perspective then, and we're going to be watching that.
Having just enrolled, I'm going to show you how to enable log ingestion. So the first thing that I do is I go into the log ingestion add-on. So what we do here is I start the configuration, then I need to generate a secure key, which is automatically copied into my clipboard, and I'm going to copy it somewhere safe. And store it, because afterwards, if you lose the key, it will have to be regenerated from scratch. Now, the option that I have here in the wizard is basically for generating a script that's going to automatically configure my device for me. I click Generate Script, and the script is automatically saved. I go into my firewall configuration, maintenance, and now I just import the script file that I generated in WebUI. As soon as the firewall updates its configuration and restarts, basically, the device is showing up, if we go back to the log ingestion screen, here we can basically view the addresses. Once the log analytics run for a little while, we will be able to go into the scores view. And here the ingested data is processed based on indicators and devices that we can basically view in the table below, split into individual grades based on categories. And there's a number of suggestions for the users as well.
So, Matthias, what's next for cloud services?
As you saw in the demos that we showed, I mean, that's what's in 3.1 of cloud service, and we are adding more and more features. One of the things that's coming up quite soon is OpenID Connect support. We are also planning to add something called an SSO portal or SyncSignal portal. So when you use this passwordless VPN service that we have, that you can also then SyncSignal into different services. So that's something that's coming. And I also want to mention something that we have in the service that is not a new feature, but something that's been there for a while, but it's a feedback button. So it's a really simple thing, but it's a button that you have in the UI. You can click on it and you can ask for, let's say, features, or you can vote on other people's requests. And that, of course, it doesn't necessarily mean that it gets implemented, but at least it's a, one of the more important way of us to getting the input directly from those that use the service. So that's a request I have to all the customers out there for the service.
I can't wait to see more services added to our cloud solutions. In the meantime, don't forget to subscribe and stay safe.